Welcome to this Wine Studies course on Hindu asceticism and its spiritual disciplines. But first of all, let me introduce myself. My name is Daniela Bevilacqua and I am a South-Asianist specialized in Hindu asceticism, which I investigated through an ethnographic and historical perspective. From 2015 to 2020, I was involved as a postdoc research fellow at SOAS for the Haṭha Yoga Project founded by the European Research Council. And my role in this project was to investigate the yogic practices of contemporary ascetics in India, focusing the attention on specific ascetic religious groups which are traditionally associated with the yoga practices as well as with the practice of austerities, that is tapasya. So in this course, I'm going to introduce these three main topics to you: asceticism, tapasya, and yoga as a sadhana, as a religious discipline. To summarize this entire course, in this first session, I'm going to introduce the topic of Hindu asceticism, providing a historical background of its origin and developments, to highlight then sectarian differences, and especially the main differences between Shaiva and Vaishnava ascetic groups. In the second session, I will introduce the topic of tapas. Tapas can be interpreted as an inner spiritual fire to develop through tapasyas, austerities. So in the second session, we will see how the notion of tapas developed over the centuries, adapting to changing religious context, and what were and are its uses in the ascetic context. In the last session, I will talk about yoga from the ascetic perspective, highlighting the role of yoga as a sadhana in the present. In its session, whenever possible, we will move from the past to the present. While dealing with present groups and their practices, mostly I will refer to ascetic orders from North India, such as the Dashnamis, the Nat Yogis, and the Rāmānandīs. These orders have been selected not only as they were traditionally associated to those embodied practices we are going to describe in the next sessions, but also because they represent the historical development of the religious movements I'm going to mention in this first session. In general, to address ascetics, I will use the words sadhu, which means holy man, and baba, which means father. Both are quite general words and are commonly used in South Asia for religious people. In the case of women, I will use the word sadvi, that is the female form of sadhu, or mata, which means mother. In this first session, I will broadly outline the main stages of the historical development of Hindu asceticism. And I say Hindu because I'm not going to pay attention on Buddhism and Jainism, but mostly on those religious currents that were fundamental for the development of groups related to what is today called Hinduism. As first, I will present the substratum from which apparently various ascetic streams flowed, to provide an abrahamical understanding of asceticism. To follow, I will present the main religious events which brought fundamental changes to the Indian religious landscape: the rising of Shaiva orders, tantric traditions, Vaishnava groups, and Bhakti, since they all influenced the organization of several